Hi guys, and welcome to Soft Hints. In this chapter 9, you can test your knowledge against real practical problems and you can learn a lot of new things which I will present in this video. We're going to work with this text file. You can find the words and how they are separated by a new line. First, we are going to read this file. You need to download it and put the file next to your Python script. Then read the file. Now you can see that we have object, which is text IO wrapper. And now we can read words one by one by using readLine method. And you can see that we have the first one. At the end, we have the separator for the new line. And this is documentation for this method. Right now, if we execute again, we will have different word, because this object remembers the last place what information was read, and we can continue by reading next words, but this time we can remove the ending new line symbol. And as you can see right now, we don't have this new line symbol. This symbol is going to depend on your system. Is it Windows, Linux, and so on? But you see this in future when you're working on real examples. And now let's see some of the words. This is the last one, because I don't want to use this code which is printing all of the words, because it's going to break my browser. And let's start with the first exercises. The first one is to write a program which is reading the text file and prints only the words which have more than 20 characters. I will do it in a bit more advanced way by using Pandas, which is a Python library for data science. And first we are going to import the library. Then we are going to read the file by using method readCSV. You can find documentation using Google. By default is used for reading CSV files, but we can read this text file. We can provide a name for our column, because we have only one column. And let's check what we have. You can see that we have the words. We have index for each word, and we can use this index. And we can find what is the length of this structure. And now, if we want to solve get all words which have length bigger than 20, we can read all the words from this data frame. Then we can check the length. Is it bigger than 20? After running this example, we can find the words and also which place do they have in the text file. We can continue by using these advanced techniques for solving the next problems. For example, next one is really interesting one. You have a task to find all words which don't have letter E. And you can find that there is a novel which have 50,000 words without letter E. If we like to use Pandas, then we can again read all words. Then we'll need to fill, because we have some problematic places. This is something like working with data, trying to make it a bit better. Then we are going to search, do we have letter E in the word? And if yes, we are going to filter from all the words. And as you can see right now, from all the words in this text file, this number of words don't have letter E, and this is the number which have letter E. So in this way, you can really easily find the total number and also get some information for them. For example, you can use head, and you're going to have only the first examples, or you can get the last examples which have letter E. And this is a really powerful technique to use pandas. But let's continue with the next exercises according to the book. So if we like to implement a function which is verifying if a given word have letter E, then we can use this approach, iterating through all letters in the word and then checking do we have letter E. If this is the case, then we are going to return false, otherwise we will return true. And if you like, we can do a test and also do a short debug by using pixidust library. And let's see how it's working. So we are starting with the first letter. You can follow the variables here. Then we are going to continue with next one. And as you can see, we have E. That's why we are going to end and return false. And this is how the program is working. Next one, it's working in a similar way, but the only difference is that we have in instead of two equal signs. So we are going to verify, are we avoiding any of them? Because we have multiple letters right now and not only one. That's why we need to use different operator for this avoid function. As you can see here, we have false and we can again debug the function just quickly to see what is going on. This time we have letter, which is H, but we are checking against several letters and not only for one. And only at the last iteration for this word we have false, and now we'll have true. So let's continue with two really similar functions, which are uses only and use all. They are pretty similar. The difference is that we are changing the order that we are using. For example, here we have letter in word and here we have in required. This is the difference that we have. We change places of those two for these two functions, but they're pretty similar. And also I wanted to show you how they work. So let's show one of them. Again, we're iterating to all of the words, but this time we're negating the operator by using not, and we are saying if this letter is not part of the available ones, then we're going to return false. And you can see letter T, it's not part of the available ones in this case, and that's why we'll have false as return. And here I wanted just to make a small emphasis on difference on some small details, whether you're searching from small to big one or the reverse. Here we have two similar examples. You can see that we have ABC and the whole alphabet, and in first example we are searching from small to the bigger one, and then we are searching from big, because we are changing the variables here, to the small one. And let's check what is going to happen about these small differences and how they can impact our performance. And as you can see here, we have much slower execution comparing to this one. Of course, all of this is pretty, how to say, pretty amateur. But in this case, it's just to show you that small difference in the program can make a huge impact on performance and so on. And let's say that in this way, you can use Timeit in order to record performance for your programs and then compare which solution to take if you have more than one solution. Okay, let's move to the next one, which is about looping with indices. and in this case we need to check is a given word abecedarian and do we have each letter from the previous place to be precessor to the next one, comparing the adjacent letters. So we can see that here this is the case, no matter that we have two letters which are one and the same, and we can see how this is working in practice. So first we create variable previous, which is the start letter of the word, and then we are going to iterate through this word by comparing C is the current and previous is the previous one. As you can see in the first example, they are one and the same. And then we are going to set previous to the current one and we are slowly crawling the letters in the word. And you can see that we are testing previous, which is H, against the current, which is I. And until we reach the end of the word, we are going to return true if all the cases are okay, otherwise we will have false if one of the pairs is not matching this requirement. And this is how this function is working. We are having a temporary variable previous and we are changing the temporary variable on each iteration, then comparing to the current state. And this is a powerful programming technique which can be used in your everyday life. Of course, we can rewrite the function using a recursion. And in this way, we are going to start with the first two letters, do a comparison with bracket operator, and then we are going to decrease the word. Then we are going to start from the first character, meaning that we are getting index 1, and then we are going to continue until the end of the word. And if we have a successful execution and reaching the end, then we will return true. Otherwise, if we break the condition, then we will have false. And this is how you can use recursion for this function. And another option is to use while for the same purpose. And let's move to the next one, because this while is pretty similar to the previous one. Next one is to check is a given word palindrome or not. And you can find example function here. In this case, we will have two indices. First is starting from the beginning of the word and the next is starting from the end of the word. We are starting to crawl from the end and the beginning to the mid and comparing are the words similar or not by using this condition here. We need to change the iterators and return false if this is not the case. Of course, you can use a different logic. For example, you can reverse the word. And in this case, you can just compare if the reversed word is similar to the one you have in the start. And here you need to think for some edge cases, for example, for an empty string, what you need to do and are you going to work with numbers and so on. And let's continue with some interesting example, again with extended slicing. For example, you can test a given word, is it palindrome or not, by using this slicing, which is going to reverse the word, and then you can test is the word exactly the same as the reversed one, and you can find the difference in the solutions, the number of the lines, and which is more easy for you to understand and also to work with. And this is all about programming and how do you think, and not just only for the basics and how to use them. It's how to think and how to make better and easy to read solutions. And now let's continue with one last exercise, which is a really interesting one. And you have a puzzle. You can find more information on this link here. The idea is to find words from this initial file, which have three sequence double letters. In this case, you can see bookkeeper have a double O, K and E. And we are searching only for this kind of words. And if we have committee with double M, T and E, this is not the case because we have E, which is separating them. And we need to write a program which can extract all these kind of words from this file. In this case, you can find my solution, which is a bit clumsy, let's say, but it's unique one. And I suggest to you to start with writing your own solutions until you make it work, and only then to try to find better solution and analyze what you can improve in your original solution, and also how to think about a given problem. In this case, we are going to define a function. We have a word and we'll have a counter, which is counting how many actually this counter is not needed. We can remove it. It was part from the previous solution. And if we have a word which have less than 5 letters, then we return false because we don't have obviously 6 letters and we will not have these 3 pairs. And then we can enumerate or iterate all the letters in the word. We will have each letter and index for the letter. After that, we are going to check, is the first letter equal to the second one? If so, then we are going to check next to you, and so on by this long if. And if this is the case, we are going to return true. If not, we are going to continue with our iteration until we face this condition. If not, we are going to return false. And this is how the function is working. And since we have edge case, in case we reach close to the end of the word, we need to stop the execution, otherwise we will get index out of range. And this statement, minus 5, is keeping us from this problem. And let's check what is going to happen. In this case, you can see that program is working as expected, but we are going to use again pandas, then read each word in this file one by one, running the previously defined function. You can see it here, and print only the words which are returning true. And as you can see right now, from this example, we have only few words which are matching this condition, and you can find that they're almost identical and they have one and the same origin. And in general, I would advise for you to try to solve all of these exercises by yourself and see what is not working or what is difficult for you. And also you can share in your comments below and I will try to help you. In general, you might have more than one solution in programming, and this is really the case. You need to find the advantage and disadvantage of the solution, and also you need to think about performance, because in this case we might work with hundreds, but in other case we might work with millions. So that's all for this video. If you have any ideas, problems or suggestions, please do share them in the comment section below. Thank you for watching and see you next time.